طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So as we said before, for each segment you must have a sequence number. This is a must. There's no option. Okay? And then you have to ask yourself, if this is an acknowledgement, what is the acknowledgement number? And then you have to think about what flags do you need to set, if any. Okay? If it's during connection establishment, then we need to set the send flag. If it's during connection termination, we need to set that fin flag. If it's neither, then we don't have to set anything. For sending data, we don't have to set any control flags. Okay? So at the beginning, A will have some buffer with some segments. Assuming that all these segments have been sent and A does not have any segments to send to B anymore, then A will send the fin to start gracefully disconnecting from B. So the sequence number here, I give it to you, which is 3000. It's not an acknowledgement for anything, so I don't have to set the acknowledgement number. And the control flag here is fin. And the message is sent. Okay, this message has zero size, has no data. So here, fin received. Okay? Then, B will have to acknowledge that. Okay? When B sends the fin, pay attention to that, B may still have some segments in the buffer. So just the fact that A has finished sending its segments to B, it doesn't mean that B does not have anything to send back to A. So B may still have some segments in the buffer. So that's why here typically we send the acknowledgement only. Okay? We don't combine the acknowledgement with the fin from B. So that's why the connection establishment, we call it three-way handshake. Three-way because it's only three messages. And usually we combine the acknowledgement with the send from B. Because neither of them have any data to send to each other. Listen, the buffers are still empty. But here, there may still be some segments in the buffer. So you send fin only when you finish sending everything. Okay? So this acknowledgement, again, has a sequence number. And it has an acknowledgement number. Acknowledgement number here is based on this. Acknowledgement number is always based on the sequence number from the other side. So here, the acknowledgement number, because the segment size is zero, the acknowledgement number has to increment. Okay? So here, the acknowledgement number is 3001. And the control flag here is ACK only, because we set the acknowledgement number. Nothing else. When B finishes sending all these segments, then and only then, it needs to send a fin message. This fin message, it has a sequence number, as I told you here, this sequence number is 1000. So just for completeness, this sequence number has to be 999. Okay, because I told, the question says here that B will finish at 1000. If you put this 1000 and this 1001, it's fine. But yani, this is yani, for correctness. Yeah. Okay. And then the control flag here is fin. So here there's sequence number. It's not an acknowledgement for anything, so I don't have to set the acknowledgement. The acknowledgement has been sent already. Okay. And here, A has to respond back with an acknowledgement. This acknowledgement has a sequence number of 3001. And the acknowledgement number is 1001. And the control flag, ACK. That's it. What else? We finished the connection termination. So here is four messages in the connection establishment. It's called three-way handshake. Okay. Okay. So this this activity explains the TCP flow control. So here, okay, the connection is already established. Well, as we assume that the connection is already established, and now we are in the communication phase, which means that we need to send data back and forth. Okay, so here the question says, show the timing segments from A to B, knowing that A has a file of 600 bytes. So we have a file of 600 bytes. This is the data that starts at sequence 200. Yani A will start at sequence 200. And the segment size is 100. So each segment has a size of 100. So how many segments do we need for the whole file?
Six
segments. Okay, easy. And B has a window size of 300. So what does this tell you? This tells you that A can send three segments at once before it waits for acknowledgement. And that's how we control the speed. Okay? Until I receive an acknowledgement from B that tells me what is the new window size, okay, I will wait. After three segments, I will have to wait forever. Okay, so I must receive acknowledgement at the latest after sending the three segments before continuing to send any more messages. Okay, which means that if everything goes well, which here the assumption is that everything goes well, and we'll see if it's otherwise later, but if everything goes well here, then I need two rounds, sending three segments, wait forever until I receive the acknowledgement, and then send another three segments, and hopefully things will go well, and then we will finish sending the file. So six total segments, send first three, wait for acknowledgement, and then send the other three. So we just need to adjust and set the sequence numbers. Here, of course, there is no send or fin. Connection is already established before, and we're not going to terminate the connection after that, and maybe A has some more data. I didn't tell you here that after sending this file, you have to terminate the connection. I didn't tell you that. So you will not assume that the connection will terminate automatically. So we just need to worry about sending the segments for that file only during the communication phase. Okay? So we just need to put the six segments and highlight where is the acknowledgement, what flags do we need to set, what is the sequence number of each segment. Wada? Okay, so the first, so A will have to send, as we said, A will have to send three segments starting from sequence number 200, right? This is data, no control flags, and it's no acknowledgement, so that's it, okay? So we'll send this segment. This segment has a size of 100 bytes, okay? So it will finish at sequence 299, exactly. So the next segment will have a sequence of 300. And I don't have to wait for acknowledgement to send this segment. The third one will have a sequence number of 400. And this one is 100, this one is 100. Here, data received. Data received, data received, okay? Assuming that the network is slow and B will have to absorb all these segments before it sends an acknowledgement, okay? Then, when B sends the acknowledgement, this acknowledgement has to have a sequence number, which I didn't give it to you. You put it anything, put it 1,000, anything. Doesn't matter. The important thing is the acknowledgement. The acknowledgement here is Eva?
401.
Wrong.
No, 500.
It's actually 400 plus this.
because I finished 400, it's starting
right.
You finished 499.
Yes, you finished at exactly 499. So you are telling A, please send me 500. Or in other words, this acknowledgement is the next sequence number here. So this sequence number is 500. So the acknowledgement here is 500. And here the control flag is ACK. We have to set the control flag. Okay? Then when we send the 500, because assuming that B will send us the acknowledgement with the window size, and the window size is still 300. I didn't give you otherwise, because the window size will keep the same. Okay? So the window size is 300, which means that A can send another three signals. So the first one is at 500. Second one is sequence number 600. And then the sequence number is 700. So this one is 100. This one is 100. This one will finish at 799. Right? So here, B will send an acknowledgement with a sequence number is... Sequence number... Here, remember the acknowledgement has a data size of 0. This is only acknowledgement. I'm not sending any data back to A. I'm just sending an acknowledgement. I don't have to combine any data, because I didn't tell you that B is sending back any data. Okay? Which means that this is 1000 and this is 1001. And because this is the acknowledgement, so I set the acknowledgement to 800. Right? And the control flag is acknowledged. That's it. The file is finished. You don't go forever, right? Because I told you that the file size is 600. So we only need to send these six segments. And here, the assumption is that no error happened. Everything is smooth. And no network problems. And nothing was lost and everything. So next time, inshallah, we'll talk about when something goes wrong in the middle. Now what do we do? Start it at anything. The important thing is the sequence number here will increment because the data size here is zero.
By one
because the data size here is zero. The sequence number is always a is always the sequence number here is always this plus this.
Yes. Yes. But it has to increment.
Yeah.
It has to increment because you cannot use the same segment twice with the same sequence number. It's not acceptable. So here, this one is 1000 and the segment size is zero. There's no segment size. So we have to increment. Yes. So at least you have to increment. Mafhoom kada?
On the receiving end from A, when they send the acknowledgement, we say...
Acknowledgement received.
Acknowledgement received.
That's it.
That's it.
Yes. And usually, any data that gets sent from B to A, it needs to include the window size. It needs to include the window size every time. Like if B were to send an acknowledgement here, I don't want to confuse you, but it may happen. Some variations of TCP, it actually allows the B to send the acknowledgement in the middle. So if I send the acknowledgement here, the window size may change to 200 instead of 300, because there is only 100 in the buffer, and maybe the window size will get reduced. But that also depends on the fact that whether the application has absorbed this segment or not. So it may be 200 or 300, depending on the speed of the application from the layer above. Okay? So whether or not this segment has been consumed or not. Or it may actually reduce below 200 in the case of congestion. So if I find that the network is too slow, then regardless of my buffer, I will reduce it to maybe 100. Okay? So we don't want to get into these details. For us, this is like the happy path. So will stop here at the happy path without getting into more details, because TCP has a lot of more details that it will require like three lectures to talk about.
Here the size is 600 bytes,
right? Right.
Why you complete till 700?
Because we start at 200. We actually finished at 799. Because this starts from 700, and we have 100 bytes. So the first byte is 700. So it ends at 799. The next one will start at 800. But we don't have to send 800 because the file is done. We sent six segments. Once we finish the six segments, we don't have to do anything else. So we'll stop here.
At the receiving end of A, we accept the acknowledgement. Should we also accept the window?
Yes, Mawa. We assume here that the window size did not change. And we sent all the three segments, and the three segments have been consumed. And the window size will not change. I didn't tell you that the window size changed.
Yeah.
So we assume that when B sends the acknowledgement, this means that all the three segments have been consumed already. And the buffer is available for you to send another three segments.
So the sequence number and B acknowledgement?
Yeah, because I didn't give it to you. Starts from anything.
It just has to be counted by one.
But yeah, it's just for completeness that, as I said, you must set the sequence number. It's not an option. You must set the sequence number to something. Okay? So if it's clear from the question what to set it, then you can use this number. Otherwise, put it anything.